Hey guys, today I am here to clearly explain that how to solve the problems of probability of this part here. First part here, find the probability for each of the following events if an odd number appears in a single toss of a fair dice. Next, number two, the sum A appears in a single toss of a pair of fair dice. Find the probability of that. And number third, at least one head appears in three tosses of a fair coin. Find the probability of that. I will solve out these questions of probability with concepts, tricks, and secrets that probability will make very, very easy. And you can easily solve the all problems of probability after watching this lecture. So don't miss this video and must watch this video from starting to end. And without wasting any time, let's start the lecture. So here, first of all, I'm going to solve the first question here. How to find the probability if an odd number appears? Let's suppose that A is equal to odd number. Let's suppose that A is equal to odd number. What is that? What is the odd number? Next statement is here, appears in a single toss of a fair die. You know that a die has sample size 1 for one dice. For one die, we have only 6 sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And what is that? This is the sample space of one die. This goes, this has 6 sides. But what is odd number? Very simply, odd number shows here. This F, 1 is the odd number, we put here. Simply, very easy. Third is the odd number, put here. 5 is the odd number, put here. So this is the even. You must remember, this A is the even. And this is the sample space. This is the total sample space. Now, the question is very, very important. Find the probability. Question is that, find the probability. That means, find the probability of A. What is the probability of A? That's the question. So here, we know that probability of A is equal to number in A, number in even, divided by number in sample space. So here, you can count out that 1, 2, 3. So number in A are 3 divided by number in sample space. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 numbers put here. 3 by 6, 3 by 2, 3 by 3 to the 6. We will get 1 by 2 is equal to 0.5. So that's the probability of A if odd number appears in a single toss of a pair of die. Next move the second question. So let's solve the second question. Find the probability if the sum A appears. Let's suppose that B is equal to sum A. B is equal to sum A. The question is that what is sum A? For this, move the next part. In a single toss of a pair of a fair dice. This is simple. You know that for one die. You know that I already discussed for one dice. Sample space is always equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But here is the pair of fair die. Here is the pair. Pair of a fair dice. Pair of a fair dice. For pair of fair dice, must remember that sample space is always equal to 1, 1, up to so on, 6, 6. And you know that these are the 6 sides, but this has the 36 sides. Must remember, this is has 6 sides, but this is the, for pair of, you can say that pair, you can say that double, sample space is always equal to 1, 1, up so on, 6, 6. These are the 36 sides. If you want to clear this concept, how are the 36 samples, must watch this video next. Thank you. just subtract. Next bracket, 1, 2, 6 brackets. Next 1, 2, 3, 4. Next will be here, 4, 5. And next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And last will be 6. So first of all, I put here, 1, commas, 1, commas, 1. Next will be 1, 1, comma, and 1. That's it. Simply, next step, I will put here 6. That's now, the row will be 6 and column will be 6. So put one here, put commas, commas, and next, simply follow the step, commas. Now I'm going to tell you the making how to make the 36 up. A very easy method. Next will be here, next, and next loss will be here, next step. Next will be here. Here we'll put 1, I will put here 2. 2 commas. That's clear. And next step will be here. Now again will be put the columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And last will be 6. 1, 2, so here will be 3. 3 commas. That's clear. Next step will be here. 4. 4, 5, just up to 6. Next. Commas. Next. 1, 2, 3, that will be here. 4. 4 commas. That's clear. Next will be here. 5. 1. 1 commas. 3, 4, 5, and next will be commas 6. So here will be here 4, and will be 5, 5 commas. That's clear. And that last step is here 6, 1 commas, 2 commas, 3, and next will be here 4, 5, and last will be here 6. So putting the values here. 6. 6 commas. Very, very simple step. So that next step will be very, very easy. I will just put here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's clear. Next step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's clear. Next move here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Last step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next step here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next step. Last step here. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I am making here 36 sample. I'm making here 36. I hope that you gain a lot of points about that. How to make the sample space for 36 sample. So now here, what is that? B is equal to sum A. Sum A, very simply, 6 to. What is 6 to? Very simply, 6 to is a pair. And question is that sum 8. The question is that sum 8 appears. This means 6 plus 2 is equal to 8. So I put here 6, 2 and also put here 2, 6. That's here. This sum 8 appears shows that we will add the values here to get the sum 8. That's simply next. Next part you can hear 6, 2, 5, 3. 5, 3, you know that. 5 plus 3 is equal to 8, so I will put here the pair 5, 3. That's clear? And you can also reverse that 3, 5. I hope that you have cleared the point. The sum 8 shows here, add in the values. That's simply. Next step, 4, 4. 4, 4 is also in the pair because 4 plus 4 is equal to 8, so I will put here 4, 4. So this is the sum 8 set part. What is B sum 8? This is 6, 2, 6 plus 2, 8, 2 plus 6, 8, 5 plus 3, 8, 3 plus 5, 8, and 4 plus 4, 8. That's simply. Now, The main point is there, find the upper value. Provide the value of B. What is the probability of B? You can easily find it. Probability of B is equal to number in B divided by number in sample space. So what are the numbers in B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You put a value here, 5 divided by sample space is the 36 side. 36, you put here 36. So this is the probability of B. Now I'm going to move the third part. The third part, at least one head appears. Let's suppose that C is equal to at least one head appears. One head appears. The question is there, what is that one head appears? For that, move the next part, three tosses of a fair coin. You know that for one toss of coin, sample space is always equal to head tail. These are the two numbers. Next, for one coin, sample space equal to head, tail, and next tail. So these are the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, 4, 3 tosses. The question is here, 3 tosses, for 3 tosses of a fair coin, for that, sample space will be equal to, these are 2, these are 4, 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8, so these are the 8 numbers. For 3 tosses, numbers will be here 8. So here head, next head, tail, and next tail, head, and next part is here tail, head, and next will be here tail, head, and next head, tail, that's clear, and next will be here head, tail, head, and next tail. So count that here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So these are the 8 samples. You have to calculate the probability of C. What is the probability of C? Probability of C is equal to number in C divided by number in sample space. C are the numbers here. At least one head appears. So here, these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are the 7 numbers. So put here 7 divided by whole numbers are 8. So here the probability. Thanks for watching this video. Also share this lecture with your classmates and friends so that they also have a benefit of it. And don't forget to like and subscribe this video. Goodbye.